Thank you. As for entertaining, I hope that being in this beautiful edifice that is governed by this great pastor, along with the great officers and members of this church, will be entertaining to you. Inspirationally, we will be lifted in spirit by the great voices that flow from the lips of this choir. Now, as for rewarding, this part, if you allow God to come into your soul, take control of your soul, your mind, and in your heart, you will be rewarded with what God has laid upon Brother Paul's heart to give us today. I know he will surely reward us today. See, there's a difference between believing and knowing. To believe is to consider to be honest and true. To know is to recognize this being the same as something previously known. So you can believe, and that's saying, just like I said in the definition, to consider. That's leaving room for doubt. But when you know that you know that you know, there's no room for doubt. Amen. Psalms 135 and 5 said, "For I know that the Lord is great, and that our Lord is above all gods." Like I said earlier, we're not here to prolong your time, but we hope that you will relax and enjoy this program. If you will take attention to the program, it says, presiding Brother David Vincent Wright, myself. We've already had our procession with our Masons and Stars. And if you will now join us in hymn number 19, Brother Weave Have Met to Worship, and sing along with us. The words of the song are printed on the back of the program. Would you please stand and join with us in this song?
Brother, we have met to worship and adore the Lord our Lord. Will you pray and give all your power while we try? home to heaven at his table, we'll sit down. Christ will burn himself and serve us with sweet manna all around.
It is at this time that we'll be entertained by Brother Chris Singletary with our protocol.
To the most wishful Grand Master of the state of South Carolina, Honorable Charles W. Davenport, to all elected and appointed Grand Lodge officers, to the special deputies, number 3, Masonic District, Brother C.A. Myrie, wishful masters, wardens, brethren, to all visiting Grand Lodge officers and brothers, to the grand worthy matron of Grand Chapter of the Order of the Eastern Stars of the state of South Carolina, grand worthy patrons, worthy matrons, worthy patron sisters, to all the coordinates, attendants, and adopted bodies, owing allegiance to the most wishful prince, Grand Lodge of the Judiciary of South Carolina. The protocol for this program has been established.
We will now have prayer by Brother Ernest Paul.
Lord, I give you thanks right now, Lord, for this moment, dear Lord. Father, you please remember those that are sick right now, Lord. Lord, that don't have food and shelter, dear Lord. Bless right now, Lord. Remember all those mankind, dear Lord. Father, remember those that don't know their job, dear Lord. Father, don't know where to live, dear Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless us right now, Lord. Father, this month I give you thanks right now, Lord. Look at my brothers, dear Lord. Bless them right now. Look at my sisters. Bless them, dear Lord. Lord, I thank you for everything you've done for us, dear Lord. Lord, in the name of Jesus, bless right now. This is your servant prayer. Amen.
We will have scripture by Brother Marcus Lee.
Like the precious ointment upon the beard, upon the head, ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, and went down the skirt of his garment, as the dew of Hermon, and as the dew of descent upon the mount of Zion, for the Lord commanded and blessed even life forevermore. Read from Psalms 133.
We will now have a selection from the Flat Rock Inspirational Choir.
first like to say thank you for the invitation to be with you, but, and we don't like to make excuses, but we are without music today. And we had a special selection that we were going to sing that we were going to be unable to sing because of the lack of music. So we ask that you try to enjoy what we sing, and maybe the next time we'll have some music. But we have a funeral in the area, and some of members of musicians went to the funeral. So if we make mistakes, just take them for the...
Now that we have our inspiration, we're ready to receive our welcome. I'll make a correction on the program, and the welcome will be given by Ms. Miranda Young. This will be followed by a response from Brother Tracy Gunter.
afternoon.
Good afternoon.
First, give all the God, protocol, council, and staff, for the brothers, Canada, Vietnam, and sisters. We take that warm weapon and try to use it in God's name. Thank you.
At this time, we will be having greetings coming from our sisters. If a representative of the Knights of Pythagoras are here, any other concordant bodies, and our special deputy at this time. First, starting with our sister, Sister Alice Rapley, Worldly Matron, the Queen of Abbeville Chapter of Order of Eastern Star, number 236. Sister Rapley. We will now have greetings from Sister Barnett Belcher, Royal Matron of Brownlee Chapter number 279, Order of Eastern Star.
Journey you never. God bless you. Thank you so much for having us here from the Brownlee Chapter.
Do we have a representative for the Knights of Pythagoras here? Any other concordant bodies? Past Master Bradley, will you bring greetings from the consistory? Knights of Pythagoras, please. It is at this time that I present to you our Special Deputy of our Lodge, Special Deputy of the 3rd Masonic District, Most Wishful Prince Hall Grand Lodge of State of South Carolina, Brother C.A. Myrick.
Thank you, Brother Master Ceremony, to the Master Ceremony, the guest speaker. Brother Paul, jurisdiction North Carolina, Worship Master, Brother Thomas, and Brother Rapley, to Sister Rapley, and Sister Belcher, for the Eastern Stars, Brothers of the Craft, Sisters of the Sisterhood, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. We're very proud to be in your midst, as always, and always give us an inspiration when we come to be with you. And we bring greetings from the Most Worshipful Grand Lodge State of South Carolina, Brother Charles W. Davenport, our Most Worshipful Grand Master, also from District 3, our Brother William Hendricks, who is our District Deputy. And we want to congratulate you on this date, which is Prince Hall, which is something that we should be proud of. As I was looking through a publication here that was published sometime recently, and while I'm standing too, I bring you greetings from our Piedmont Consistory, number 169, out of Greenville. There were some things listed, and they were as accomplishments of Prince Hall. And one of the accomplishments was that he petitioned General George Washington to admit men of color to the Continental Army. Number two, he led the entire army, entire lodge membership, in support of Governor Borden during the rebellion of Daniel Shea and his group. Number three, he petitioned the Massachusetts State of Legislature for funds to educate children of color. Number four, he opened his house as a school to provide an educational opportunity to adults of color. Number five, he petitioned the state legislature to grant all citizens of color the right to own real property to vote in all elections. And lastly, he served as a special deputy to the Grand Lodge of England. At times, we are not able to do all of these things, but as we see the accomplishment of what Prince Hall accomplished, the things that he accomplished, there are things that we can accomplish in our community as we see our age, as we see those that are sick, as we see our young people. There is a job for each of us to do. Times are getting tougher now. More education is required on jobs or whatever field you might be in, or more education is required. So this is why we want to urge all of our young people, especially, study hard, learn all you can. Thank you.
At this time, I will be presenting the person that will introduce our speaker, Brother Claude Thomas, Worship Master, Presbyterian Lodge number 181. But after the introduction from Brother Thomas, we will have a selection from this choir. At this time, I present to you Brother Claude Thomas.
My brothers and my sisters, ladies and gentlemen, we are indeed in for a treat today. For the person who will bring the message to us today truly espouses the scripture that says we must work while it is still day, for when darkness comes, no man can work it. His accomplishments are many. He hails from Winston-Salem, North Carolina, and I think, and I'm pretty sure with a name like Paul, he's probably from around here somewhere. I didn't ask him, but I'm sure he's no stranger to this area. He and his wife Joyce are the parents of three sons, Charles, James, and Jerome. His church affiliation, he's a member of the New Jerusalem Baptist Church, where he serves as an ordained deacon and chairman of the trustee board. He's a treasurer and co-chairman of the Finance and Budget Committee. He's a member of the Pastor's Aid Club and member of the Forsyth County Deacons Union and member of the Building Fund Committee. His education, educated in Anderson County Public Schools, Anderson County, South Carolina. His management seminars are too numerous to name at this time, but he's been involved in many. His occupation, people like to know, what do you do? What else do you do? He's employed by the R.J. Reynolds Industries. His present job title is that of Technologist 3, supervising making, packing, and filter areas of the R.J. Reynolds Research and Development. His community service, he's a former adult counselor for the 14th Street Recreation Center, United Way referral agent, life member NAACP, instituted Kids Day for underprivileged children, actively involved in role model program at Mineral Springs School and William B. Sims Recreation Center. Also, he's active in the Forsyth County Prison Ministries. His Masonic affiliations. He's a member of Salem Lodge number 139, King Solomon's Consistory number 64. Not only that, but he went up the other side of the tree and is a member of the Holy Arch, Knights of Templar, Sethos Temple number 170, Past Masters Council, Meridian Chapter number 308. He's also an Eastern Star, past member of the Board of Directors of Winston-Salem Masonic Corporation. As I said, his accomplishments are many. He has earned many honors throughout his life, and one that I would like to share with you is that he's an honorary 33rd degree Mason, and he received that honor in 1998. The person who is coming to us now, we ask that you give him your attention. I didn't name everything, just a few of them. So before the choir, after the choir comes, and we give to you without hesitation, mental reservation, secret evasion of the mind, not further equivocation, I present and introduce to you the Right Wishful Grand Warden, Prince Hall Grand Lodge, Jurisdiction of North Carolina, Brother James E. Paul. Hear him as he comes.
Is there anybody here?
Anybody
here?
I want to know.
Do you love?
Do you love?
Is your right foot your slave?
singing that song, is anybody here who love my Jesus?
All right.
I want to know, do you love the Lord?
All
right. Amen. 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 Giving honor to the absent of the pastor of this great church, Reverend Cornelia Morton, to the most wishful Grand Master of the Prince Hall of South Carolina in his absence, Brother Charles W. Davenport, to Special Deputy Grand Master, Brother C.A. Myrick, to the Wishful Master of Derrick Lodge, number 370, Brother Ace Rapley, to Wishful Master of Precious Jewel Lodge, number 181, Brother Claude Thomas, to my Sisters of the Eastern Stars, Sister Ace Rapley, Worthy Matron, Queen of Abbeville Lodge, number 236, to Sister Burnett Belcher, Worthy Matron of Brown Lee Chapter, Order of the Eastern Stars, 279, and to this great master of ceremony, my brothers and sisters, good evening.
Good evening.
Well, that's right, I'm a Paul. And I guess I must admit, it's an honor for me to, for your brothers and sisters to agree to having me to be your speaker this afternoon at this great Prince Hall Day that Brother Thomas just have gave us some insight on the accomplishment of this great man. I am proud to call you all my brothers and my sisters. We are not blood brothers and sisters. We don't have the same father and mother on earth, but in Heavenly Father, we do have the same parents. So
right.
Proud to have you, my brothers and sisters. If I don't have my mama to stand, she gonna have a fit, brother. If I don't have her to stand up, y'all will be saying a loss to me, and I ain't ready to go. Mom, would you stand up, please, man? That's my mother. That is my heart. I ain't gonna ask all, I ain't gonna name all my brothers and my sisters, but I see all of you, Pete, Billy, Duke, all of you. Well, y'all know everybody in South Carolina got a nickname, and I got one too. So I'm not gonna take up too much of your time, but with my family, please stand. My family and my friend that came from Winston-Salem with me, would you please stand up, please?
Amen.
nieces, nephews, grandchildren, and my brother Jefferson, Paul Jr., the one that I love so much. It's so good to see him and you here today, my brother. I thank you all from the bottom of my heart, my nieces and nephews, and I hope something that will be said here today, not only to them, to everybody here, that will give you strength, that when you leave here, that you will be a better person. You all may sit down. To my sister, Brother P.I.'s wife, I can't remember her name right now, I'm not gonna talk long. I promise. If you give me your attention for 15 or 20 minutes, I guarantee you we'll be through and we'll be on our way. Thank you. I am only one, but still I am one. I cannot do everything, but I can do something. And with the help of God, and because I cannot do everything, I will not refuse to do the some things that I can do. The title of mine, I'm not a preacher, I'm a speaker. Momentarily by the ego preacher. Lord haven't called me yet. Lord haven't called me yet, but I'll tell you one thing, I do know him, I have been with him. I know he is. The title of my little speech today is, Yes, I Am My Brother's Keeper. Now is the time for all good men and women to come to the aid of our country. The call of arms go out throughout all over the world. It's a call of action. It's a call to get up, stand up, speak up, and suit up. It's a wake-up call for us, my brothers and sisters. We have been asleep too long, and much has happened while we've been napping.
All right.
Our homes, our school, our city, churches and community, and our country needs us. We have a promise to keep to ourselves and Almighty God. Each of us made a conscientious decision to join the Brotherhood of Freemasonry. We came on with the knowledge that Freemasonry teaching and enlightenment were principles we wanted to support and share. Now, if it's some brothers, if it's some gentlemen in here that don't know about Freemasonry, y'all ought to be able to pick up your few members here this afternoon. they say that we are the secret society, but my brothers and sisters, there's nothing secret about Masonry. Anything that you want to know about Masonry, if you got a Bible, you can find it in it. You just got to know how to find it and what to find. I ain't gonna let out too many secrets here tonight, special deputy. Boy, I don't want to get a bad review from Brother Davenport, you know. So when y'all report back to him, I want you to tell him that Brother Paul stayed within the confines of his ritual.
Okay.
All right. Okay. Teaching and enlightenment. We learn that Freemasonry teach the fatherhood of God and the brotherhood of man. That through intelligent self-discipline, we can discover who we are so we can understand what makes us happy. We promise to obey, support, and uphold the teaching, the practice and teaching of this great organization. To fight for freedom and justice for all. To help eradicate violence and injustice. To oppose intolerance, to aid the widows and orphans, and to support our government and civic leaders in their endeavor to restore order and peace to our street and our city. But what has happened along the way? Did we lose sight of our goals? Have we lost the vision that we want to leave to our children and grandchildren? Have we become complacent with the way things are? Do we feel that we can't make a difference? Are we just too busy becoming successful in our own little world? We have closed our eyes. We have closed our eyes to the increase in violence that us brothers and sisters promised to eradicate? Do we not hear the cries of the widows and the orphan and the senior citizen we promised to protect? Did we not notice that democracy is taking a backseat to dictatorship? Are we aware that the separation of government and churches gets smaller every day? Or as churches are forced to pay more taxes, and even some are even losing their tax exempt status? Where were the Masons, the Christians, the stars when prayer was voted out of our school? Did we allow, how did we allow children to take control of our home? Allow our children to take control of our home when our children come and say, we want a pair of Michael Jordan shoes that costs $100 or $200, or a designer jacket or something, and we don't even have enough money to buy our medicine or to pay our rent. It's time for us to reclaim our home from our children. Amen. What were we doing when society, when society replaced honesty, truth, and integrity with dishonesty and immorality, and convinced the world that this was progress? Why were we at the stern when the lawmaker changed the Ten Commandments to the Ten Suggestions? When thou shalt not kill was changed to it's a woman's right to control her body? When homosexuality ceased to be a sin, but it became an alternate lifestyle? When love your neighbor became kill your neighbor? When not sparing the rod meant parents was arrested for child abuse? I thank God for my mother, because if they had child abuse back in the day, she'd still be making time. Tell you, I'm sure I know Curtis and P.I. and them and Marge and Uncle Tim and them did them the same way. They make you go get a switch and bring it back, and then they will use it on you. The word of God said that he that spared the rod hated his son. That's not Brother Paul saying, the word of God said it. He that spares the rod hated his son. When honor thy father and thy mother were replaced with kill your father or mother. And my brother and sister, you know this happening every day. If they don't allow you to stay out as late as you wish. When thou shalt not commit adultery is considered outdated because it's the 21st century. When the Bible, God's word, has described as an inadequate history book. God's word, professors teaching in school that if the Bible is not true, it's just an inadequate history book. And government officials are saying the same thing. Did you know that a serious crime is committed every 3.5 seconds? A robbery is committed every 83 seconds? A murder, a human life is taken every 27 minutes? The USA has more than 9 million alcoholics and 500,000 heroin addicts. Suicide is the second largest killer of teenagers. One of every two marriages ends in divorce. 1.3 million couples live together without the benefit of marriage. Now, if I hurt somebody in here, you just go ahead to bleed. That's all I'm doing. I'm coming right from the word of God. If I hurt you, if I'm wrong, I apologize. But if I'm right, before I take it back, I add some more to it for somebody. More and more babies are having babies. Any man can get a baby, but it takes a real man to be a father of a child. Abortion clinic, pornography stores, and drug stores on every street corner. prescription for tranquilizer outnumber the prescription for antibiotics. I was reading in a book the other day, that, and the doctor said that 90% of the people that come to the doctor are not sick. Stress. Stress of this old world is pressing them down. It's not, they are not physically sick. They are mentally sick, you know. That's what I'm not crazy now, just something wrong with the body. Okay. Our teenagers are standing on the corner with a 40 in their hand. Y'all know what a 40 is? I had to ask around to find out what it was. Standing on the corner with a 40 in their hand, asking, what's happening, man? What's happening? And nobody knows what's happening. And no one, what happened? No one knows what's happening. They need answers, guidance, leaders, and role models. Kids need to see men and women that will say what they mean and mean what they say. And brothers and sisters, this is part of our job. We have a group committed to saving the whale, the rainforest, the mink, the mantee, the sea turtle, the eagles, and the snail. It's time we commit ourselves to saving our children, our home, and our family. Amen. America is at war, and the most of us don't even know it. Right. It is not just the hand that strike that is harmful, but the hand that failed to reach out to help. Proverbs 3:27 states, withholding not good from them to whom it is due, when it is in the power of thine hand to do it, putting off tomorrow the good that can be done today is a great evil. That's the word of God. The failure to meet a clear need when one has the opportunity and the resources to do so is disobedient to the word of God. The first step in overcoming procrastination is to eliminate all excuse, reason for not taking decisive and immediate action. If you are not sure which way to go, pray and move toward that situation in faith. Be like the two fishermen who got trapped in a storm in the middle of the lake. One turned to the other. He said, should we row or should we pray? His wise companion told him, say, let's do both. God has given us tools and power to overcome the world. He has promised us eternal life now and abundantly. He is our strength. Isaiah 40:31 states, but they that wait upon the Lord, he shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. We belong to God. We are his peoples and the sheep of his pasture. Brothers and sisters, don't never let nobody tell you ain't nothing. Amen. You understand me? If you can read in Genesis, when God breathed down and breathed the breath of life for you, he put some eternity in you. I don't care how low you sink or what you do, you got an advocate to get back with the Father. So don't let nobody tell you that you ain't nobody. I don't care what you possess or what you don't possess. Don't never let nobody tell you ain't nobody. We are a royal priesthood, a joint heir with Jesus Christ.
Yes,
we represent God's crowning achievement. We are most God's excellent creation. You understand me? When God made the birds and the fish of the sea and the fowl of the air, he say, let there be, but when he made us, he breathed a breath of life in us. That's why you somebody. We are his most excellent creation. We are the full expression of God. God created genius. God was at his very best when he made us. We are people that strong, proud, and enduring people. We survived slavery, family separation, racism, blatant oppression, segregation, hate crime, hanging, dragging, beating, and a multitude of other trials and tribulation. But by the grace of God, we are still here. We still have a long way to go to secure fair and equal rights and privileges. Statistics show that our forward progress has been annihilated by our backward steps. We have only to look at the news on the television or read our newspaper to remind ourselves of how far we are from our dream. June 1998, Jasper, Texas, James Byrd, 49-year-old black man, beaten, dragged, decapitated, mutilated for being a black man. Statistics tells us that young black males 18 to 20 years old are more likely to experience a serious and violent crime. Almost 1 in 10 of black murder victims are 18 to 21 years of old. Murder rate for blacks 8 times higher than any other race. Incarceration 10 times higher than any other race. We, as Masons and Stars and Christians, have left so many of the world decisions to the enemy's camp and chance that we are slowly losing all the freedoms and rights that so many of our forefathers fought and gave up their lives for. We watched as prayer was voted out of school, abortion laws passed one after another, homosexual or coming out of the closet or whatever you want to call it, took over our street, schools, and even some of our churches. We didn't want to challenge, make wave, or draw attention to ourselves. But as a great writer said, if a man doesn't stand for something, he will fall for anything. My brothers and sisters, remember, you are what you are by birth, but you are who you are by the choices that you make. Is this the legacy we are prepared to leave to our next generation? That we were men and women of chance and not choice? That we waited while chance or others to fight the good fight of faith? As we sit in our fancy home, cars and hope, perchance that won't happen, or perchance they won't vote him or her in the office, or perchance that innocent black child with no one to fight for him won't go to prison for the rest of his or her life, perchance, and yet it's still happening. We must stop being cultural Christian and become biblical Christian. Christian, there is the God that we want, but there is the God who is. My brothers and sisters, I'm here to tell you today that they are not the same. We get on our knees and pray and tell God what we want. I want this, I want that. Instead of getting on your knees and say, let thine will be done. Amen. But there's a difference between the God that we want and the God who is. And the change will come in our life when we stop seeking the God we want and start serving the God who is. We are being summoned back to our home, our churches, and our community to help build a generation in ruin. Many problems faces us, but God has promised to be with us. And with his help, we can make a difference. We must first and foremost admit that we made mistakes. We progress at the expense of our values and principles. We elected leaders that don't know where they're going, and we are following them. We tried to be friends instead of parents to our children. As we watch while a nation build on God, turn away from God. Christian, Mason, Star, it's time to step out from the confines of your home and lodges. Step out on faith and be about our Father's business.
Yes, sir.
James 1 and 8 state that a double-minded man is unstable in all his ways.
Yes, sir.
Lord have mercy. Christians should be the most decisive of all peoples. Being decisive, being focused, committing ourselves to the fulfillment of a dream is the challenge to us all. It's time we acknowledge. Now this gonna hurt somebody's feeling. I hope I don't see nobody get up and walk out the church. Bad to get up. But brother and sister, I'm gonna tell you. It's time that we acknowledge that it's not about us. Lord have mercy, some of us think it is. Just think it's about us. It's not about us. It's not about me, and it's not about you. But it's about being about our Father's business and making this world a better place. It's about the three steps in Jacob's ladder, which is faith, hope, and charity. And it could have seven: faith, hope, charity, temperance, fortitude, prudence, justice, and commitment, my brothers and sisters. But most of all, it's about lifting up the name of Jesus to a sinful and dying world. For he promised that if we lift him up, that he would draw all men unto him.
All right.
Then the most important battle of Masons and Star then is to eliminate evil in the hearts of men and women. Yeah. The fight that matter is not to be fought in the street. It's not to be fought in the jungle. It's not to be fought in outer space. But it's to be fought within that inner space, within our heart.
All right.
The change that count is not change of men and women, but change in men and women. The change in their heart. We must be committed to leave this world a better place than we found it. Total commitment has a high cost and is only attainable when we are able to exalt others above us. We can no longer sit and complain, waiting for others to take up the cause in the cross and fight our battle. There is a cross for everyone, and there is a cross for me. To win, we must be united in prayer, faith, and commitment. A house divided cannot stand and can certainly not expect to be victorious. Brothers and sisters, 1 Peter 3:8 admonish us to be ye of all one mind, having compassion one for another, love as brethren, be pitiful, be courteous, not rendering evil for evil or railing for railing. Many of our forefathers and mothers stepped out on faith to make life better for those that followed after him. Harriet Tubman, known as the mother of her people, had courage to start an underground railroad and led over 300 of her brothers and sisters out of slavery in the deep south. And back then, I can't remember, but it was back a long time ago, and they had a $40,000 reward out on Harriet Tubman. Martin Luther King Jr. realized that it was not about him, but it was about the vision, about the vision, the mission, and the dream God had given him to seek justice and equality for all mankind and to fight for a world where men would be judged by the contents of their character rather than by the color of their skin. He stepped out of his home in Atlanta, Georgia and marched for his dream and died. Little David, a shepherd boy, stepped out from tending his father's sheep to fight a giant called Goliath, and then became a king and a great writer of many of the songs that we enjoy today. Prince Hall realized that it was not about him, but it was about securing a charter for his black brothers to start their own laws, assuring them of all rights and privileges of their counterpart. No man is an island. No man stand alone. Yes, we are our brothers and sisters' keepers. In the fourth chapter of the book of Genesis, Cain asked God, "Am I my brother's keeper?" God answered, "The blood of thy brother cries out to me from the ground." The cries has continued to cry to this day from the ground. But these brothers and sisters chose not to ignore the cries or look to the other way, but they got up, spoke up, and stood up for those in need. But then there was another, prophesied by Malachi, promised by Isaiah,
all right,
and proclaimed by John the Baptist.
All right.
The light that gave hope to a dying world,
yes,
power to the weak,
mm-hmm,
peace to the confused,
yes,
comfort to the weary,
mm-hmm,
freedom to the enslaved,
yes,
and salvation to the lost.
Yes.
when our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ laid aside his purple robe of majesty, took off his crown, left his home in glory to be born in a manger, walked the streets of Galilee. He healed the sick, raised the dead, be sacrificed on Calvary cross for the remission of mankind's sin, be buried in a borrowed tomb, resurrected in 3 days to return to the right hand of God Almighty to intercede for us all. St. John the Evangelist said, he is the light. St. John the Baptist said, he was the true light. And he was the true light, and in him was life, and the life was the light of men. He is the ultimate example for mankind to follow. All the resources of God Almighty are at our disposal. He rules in all the affairs of men. Nothing is too hard for God. There's no disease he cannot heal, no condition he cannot change, and no nation he cannot restore. Amen. As I come to my conclusion, I'm reminded of a story I read. The story is that up in the forest of Lebanon. Brother, do you know anything about Lebanon? Amen. Up in the forest of Lebanon, there are cedar trees on the mountainside. And they tell me that those trees grow down, way down. They are not so tall, but they are strong and dependable. Their roots go down into the mountain. They go down until they strike a rock. And then those roots fan wise around that rock and wrap themselves around that rock and wrap themselves around that rock. And when the storms of life come, when the wind blow and tragic come in your life, and the thunderstorm come, those old cedar trees just rock from side to side. They don't bend, they don't break. They just rock from side to side. They stand up after the storm is gone, they stand up straight. We, my brothers and sisters, ought to be like the old cedar trees. When the storm come in our life,
yes, sir,
and the wind and the rain and trials and tribulation come in your life, mm-hmm, we should be able to just rock from side to side and stand up. The solid rock who will give us the courage, the boldness, and the determination to stand up for right and to help make this world a better place. If your hope is built on nothing less but Jesus Christ and his righteousness. In my closing, my brothers and sisters, I want to tell you that I am only one. I'm one, but still, I am one. And in Christ, I am somebody.
Amen.
I cannot do everything, but me, can do something. And because I cannot do everything, I will not, I shall not refuse to do the something that I can do. God bless you.
My brothers and sisters, you ought to be saying hello. The speaker told you when he got up, it was a wake-up call.
Amen.
And we all should answer that call.
Amen.
Yes, I am my brother's keeper, this topic. And that's what we need to be, our brothers and our sisters' keepers today. And not just today, every day. I said earlier that you will receive entertaining inspiration, and I knew that you would get a reward from what Brother Paul had to say. See, I prayed about this before I got up here. And I knew my blessings would come. And I just, when I claimed it as saying, I knew he would come and give us reward, that's exactly what he done.
Yes.
Thank you, Brother Paul.
Yes.
God bless you.
And we're not gonna prolong this program any further, but I had to say that then because it was on my heart. We will now have our recognition of our visitors and an announcement from our worship master, Brother Asa Rapp.
Good afternoon to each of you. The protocol has been already established, so I won't go into that. I'm certainly glad to see many of you out today to serve our Prince Hall today with us. And you're really, really, really looking good. If you feel the way I do about what Brother Paul brought us today, the message, I know it's something that you carry home with you, especially to those young grandchildren that you have coming up. Sometimes in our lives, we can be attracted by a youngster and let him get by with different things or whatever like that, and this thing just go on and on and on. And like you said, we need to get hold to him and teach him the right way to go. And the only way we can do that is teaching the way God wants us to go as grown ups. At this time, I'm going to get right on into if we have any visitors that hadn't been called upon today to sit in with us, that visit from any other jurisdiction, that like to stand and be recognized, you may do so at this time.
Good evening, my name is Brother Charles Tyson. I hail from Winston, North Carolina. I bring you greetings from Seven Lodge, number 139, which is Master Samuel J. Keys.
All right. And I was also. Thank you.
Wish Master Rapids, she's an Eastern Star too.
My name is Brother James Paul Jr.
Is there any others? I would like to also give special thanks to our special deputy, Brother Myers, for coming down today too. At this time, I'll call on Calhoun Fall Lodge number for any members that they have initiated into the third degree within the last 2 years, would you stand, please? That's Calhoun Fall, 181. Okay, would you give your name? Thank you. 370.
My name is Chris Singletary, Drill Lodge. Brother Ron Holloway, Drill Lodge, 370. Drill Lodge, 370.
All right.
Brother Darrell Lewis, Drill Lodge, 370.
Now, those are some of 370. Those are not all, there's a few of them that. And I'm not bragging on the Lord that I'm master of, but I got some young men that I'm really, really proud of. They came right in and went right on to work and seemed to be drawing attention to the others that's out in the communities and need such things as this. I try to teach them different things about masonry that is very, very important. I have some that will come to me at certain times and says, how long will it be think before I be able to wear jewelry or whatever like that? But I would like to say this. Jewelry doesn't make you a mason.
Lord have mercy.
Your apron doesn't make you a mason. This pergola that I'm wearing, it doesn't make me a mason. The hat that I wear, it doesn't make me a mason. And you are made a mason in your heart. When you distribute it out into your community, helping sick and the shut in, widows and offering, that's what a mason is all about. That's what makes you a master mason. Did I miss anyone that might be here that have anything to say? Also the stars also. If we have any stars that is visible from any other jurisdiction, you may stand and be recognized at this time. If not, I'll turn it back into the hands of our MC. Thank you and good afternoon.
Amen.
At this time, the finance committees for the two lodges will come and receive our offering. We ask that the choir give us a selection during the time we're taking up this offering. Brother Paul and Brother Calhoun.
Been good. like to thank each of you for your donation today. And now we would like Brother Ernest Paul to come to the office for the speaking.
Lord, I thank you for this moment, dear Lord. Lord, thank you for this lifting of the moment, dear Lord. Bless right now, Lord. Lord, for this, bless this child, dear Lord. Bless both men, Lord, bless right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, look at us right now, Lord. Remember, all the members of the Lord, bless them right now. Thank you for this moment, dear Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
Before we receive remarks from the grace and benediction from our Pastor Cornell Morton, we're going to ask Brother Paul if he have anything else he would like to give us. If you would come at this time, please.
I would just like to thank Brother Wright for doing such a fantastic job. I thank y'all all for giving him a hand for being such a wonderful man. I told you I ain't gonna hold you long. Would my sisters and brothers stand up? I can't go through all my grand and niece and all that. Pete and Duke, y'all stand up. Some of y'all took off work to come to hear me speak. That's my sister Mary Mackey, my brother Jeff, Ivory Lee is Duke, and Doris is Beely, and Joanne is the other one right back there. And the rest of my nieces and nephews, and Tyrone and his family, I thank all y'all for coming down here with me. And Curtis, I must thank you for getting dear Lords and precious Jewish Lords to let me come down and speak with them. And we would also like to thank Mr. Ben Coleman that came all the way from Winston-Salem to come down here and film this program for us. And I'll see that you get a copy of the tape and you'll be on television up there pretty soon, because he will show you on television. But may God continue to bless all of my Eastern Star sisters and my brother, and y'all pray that we have a safe trip back. And thank you very much. And thank the pastor, Reverend Morton, down here he is. He has. The Honorable Reverend Morton, may God continue to bless you. I want to thank you for letting me, as a servant of the Lord, stand behind your sacred desk. And I guarantee you that I did not do anything to disgrace this. And thank you for letting us use this church. May God continue to bless you. And thank you, Flat Rock, very much.
I would like to read these acknowledgments. We, the Masonic Brothers of these lodges, wish to thank the sisters, brothers, members, and friends for their participation in our Prince Hall Day celebration. Special thanks to the pastor, officers, and members of Flat Rock AME Church for the use of their beautiful edifice. Now, without further ado, I present to you the pastor of this great church, the Honorable Reverend Cornell Morton.
I greet you in Jesus' joy and in his love today. We are grateful for this presiding officer, Brother Wright, and all of you who are here today, my sisters and my brothers. We thank God in a special way for the speaker today. I was back in the tape room, and I want to say to Brother James Paul, we thank God for your message today for us. And I love your spirit, a splendid spirit. And may God continue to bless you. And this video crew that you have with you, my brother, you got it going on. I tell you, I like your style. And may God forever bless you, your family, those who've come a long distance. Let me thank God for the choir who rendered selection, and our own members of this church, Flat Rock, who served in the Mason. We're grateful for you, Curtis and others, Brother Ernest and others who are here today. Keep us in your prayers that I forever stay humble at the feet of Jesus, that he may get the glory out of my life, because when God put us here, he put us here for a purpose that we could glorify and magnify his name. And it's not my purpose to make God ashamed, because he has been good to me.
Amen.
And may God bless each of you. I think my task now is to do the grace and benediction. Are there any other saints? Yes, downstairs we have some refreshments, so immediately downstairs, please do not leave, but you may go downstairs and receive the refreshment that has already been prepared for you. Will you stand now? Our Father and our God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your many, 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 many blessings that you bestowed upon us, strengthening us all where we are weak, because God, somewhere in some area of life, we are messed up.
Mm-hmm.
But you are God, and you specialize in straightening out the mess in our lives. You specialize and keep on loving us when we come short of our purpose. Thank you, Lord, for this day, this celebration. Be with these, our sisters and our brothers, as we leave this place, and let traveling mercy ride with these persons who've come some distance. Watch over them, God, and we pray that they arrive back home safely, God. They are in your care as we lift them before you. Now, God, we ask your blessing upon the refreshment that has been prepared for us, that it may give us the nourishment and to hold us over until you can bless us, that we may die sumptuously in some other place. Bless it now. Now the grace of our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ be with us now and forevermore. And God, people said, amen.
Amen.
See you around.
Okay.
Thank you.